Speaking of authentic women's movement, this brings me to the third thing that I learned about the trans issue this year. Feminism has a complicated but very real responsibility for the transgender movement. I can hear the howls already, so let me assure you, I am not saying all feminists favor the transgender political push, because that's obviously false. I know that's not true. But I am saying that some of the most significant threads of feminism laid the groundwork for the rise of transgenderism. This became clear to me, crystal clear to me, when I was interviewing Chloe Cole, the celebrated detransitioner, the young girl who just turned 19 this past year, who is now suing Kaiser Permanente in California for what they did to her. In any case, I asked her, Chloe, what in particular prompted you to desist from trying to be a man, from trying to be a boy? And she responded by telling me that in her high school psychology class, she learned about the famous experiments that Harry Harlow did with rhesus monkeys, with the mother monkeys, the cloth monkeys, the wire monkeys, and the babies scampering to anything that seemed like a mother, whether there was food involved or not, that the babies wanted the comfort of the cloth-covered monkey, even more if there was a little clock inside her so that they would hear some ticking that might simulate a heartbeat. These are very famous experiments. You can read about them. But anyway, Chloe learned about that, those experiments, which have to do with the maternal instinct and maternal bonding and the importance of nursing and breastfeeding. She learned about that in her high school psychology class, and she thought, I want to do that. I want to have kids. And that was the moment for her that she realized that the attempt to be a boy and the surgery she had gone through and the hormones she had taken, that was all a big mistake. And when she said that to me in that interview, I was not prepared to hear that. I could not help thinking, what are we doing to our young girls? That a girl should be surprised that she wants to be a mommy, that she would be surprised that the thought of breastfeeding would be a wonderful thing. Now, for sure, the feminists are not the only people who are responsible for this. So, you know, don't get me wrong. They share their responsibility with plenty of other people, like the population control people and the capitalists who benefit from a steady flow of female labor and the pharmaceutical companies who are profiting from the hormone sales and, you know, the academic theoreticians and the media and all the rest of it. But it is undeniable that a certain kind of careerist feminism has downplayed the beauty of motherhood. Feminist orthodoxy played an outsized role in convincing women that motherhood is unnecessary and hinders the pursuit of a fulfilling life. I mean, is it really a stretch to see that this line of thinking could lead a young girl to be ill at ease with her own body, even despise her own body? These kids are sitting ducks for an ideology that tries to convince them that their female bodies are a problem to be solved by medical and social engineering. I'm aware, well aware, that many self-described feminists vehemently oppose everything about the transgender philosophy, and I'm glad. I do hope that some of you will reconsider some of your other ideological commitments. People of faith will be glad to talk with you about the beauty of male and female in the divine plan. I'm Dr. Jennifer Robeck Morse for the Ruth Institute, and I'll see you next time.